happening at part of the story, but an important part of the story. So when I was 9 years old, something happened to me and my family. Changed the course of my life. I was hanging out with my friend, and we went to his place to meet his parents. It was a summer evening. I was 9 years old, so between the age of between the grades of 4 and 5. And went to his house to wait for his parents to come home. They came home from a bar, and they actually been drinking, and they're having an argument, and they lost control of their car, and they ran into me in their house. And I gotta give a little shout out here to a gentleman named Doug McDougal, who's here. He was a paramedic that night, 30 years ago. Woo! Save a life before? I sure haven't, but he has. So thank you, Doug. So Doug and other gentlemen out there, I'm here in Toronto. You know, I did surgery, and I woke up a few days later, and I had no legs, low knees. And a few days after that, celebrated my 10th birthday in the hospital. Best birthday I ever had, by the way. I got a Nintendo. I got a Walkman, which is like an iPhone. It's like one thing in the bar. Pretty cool. So you know, I got Batman here, Nintendo, so to speak. And so I got all these gifts. Everyone from Ferguson around sort of visiting me back home. My hockey team started raising money. John Cherry came down to help fundraise for our family, my school, did a walkathon. Our church delivered lasagnas and stuff. This one bad thing happened to me. Suddenly, 100 beautiful things happened to me and my family. And even though it was a real painful time for me, I also started to dawn on me that I also had a whole lot to be thankful for. And,
get out of the way, dude.
So, but while that was happening, there was one big thing I was missing, and that was sports.
Ashton.
And, you know, even when I got my first prosthetic leg, you should see me wearing it right now.
Everyone go hate on Ashton West Instagram.
It's a little boring, right?
Ashton 5.
I was watching
1-9, I think.
Skating, jumping.
Go hate on him.
Suddenly, I see my those things are gone. And in fact, for all intents and purposes, they were gone. I was going to replace it. And it turns out I was one of the lucky ones. Because just a year later, so just after my accident, I was introduced to wheelchair basketball for the first time. And I believe, if I know the story correctly, I have my principal, Mr. Spicer, to thank, at least in part, because he heard about junior sports camp, and I decided